Try People, the original, which was coincidentally my first Broadway show. Right before it closed in the early 70s, I was a mere toddler, and naturally my parents thought, it's a perfect show to take Seth to. I don't remember much. I remember the nudity, because I literally saw this. My mother's crazy ham-fisted hand over my eyes, not cool. I remember the beginning of Aquarius, like we kind of walked down the aisle, and I remember one of the cast members was like, because I was in the aisle seat, like, watch out, we're gonna walk right by you. I remember that. And I remember an air, she came out of a trap door. Besides that, I had a nice snappy poo. However, I did love the album, and I became obsessed with Mabel Moore. Mabel Moore, like Laurie Beachman, Betty Buckley, Patti LuPone, changed the face of Broadway belting. People did not belt as high as Melba until Melba came along. It is cray cray. So first we're gonna just hear how clear as a bell she is on an F sharp. It's so clear. I'm going to give you the build-up into it. I'll give you the guy, and then I'll give you hers. Oh, my God. And by the way, FYI, I was interviewing Jim Rado, and he said he went over to Ragney's house who wrote this, and he just had, like, a list of something on one side and a list of words on the other, and that's why it's like, ain't got no, you know, mother, and then they comment. It's from his weird poetry. He had, like, a list here and a list there. Here we go.
Ain't got no mother, ain't got no culture, ain't got no friends, ain't got no schooling, ain't got no shine, ain't got no underwear, ain't got no soul, ain't got no A-train, ain't got no mind.
Sit right here.
Ain't got no sports, ain't got no dogs, ain't got no work, ain't got no boys, ain't got no pennies, ain't got no friends.
It's so perfect, the pitch, right on that F sharp. God.
Ain't got no God.
Okay, the next thing she sings, well, not really the next thing, but the next thing I'm gonna play is Flesh Failures, which is Let the Sun Shine In. And she's just belting up a crazy storm. She belts the F sharp, her signature F sharp, which she just belted and ain't got no, then belts it again and actually cracks tip of the hat to Barbara Streisand and Funny Girl at the end of Don't Run to My Parade, that crack. But she full out cracks on it, but I just sort of love it. I hate, you know, I'm not really into like the whole perfect CD. I hate that nowadays everything is like, is auto-tune and glee, and everything is punched in, makes me cray-cray. So I actually like the crack, because she still sounds amazing. Here, listen to this. So this is versus Sheila, not Melba. As soon as it gets too high, Melba takes over, she gets the mic. Melba's like, tap, tap. She goes.
With supreme visions of lonely tunes.
She still hits it. There's just a crack attached to it. And I say, brava. Finally, her pièce de résistance. White boys. Or she calls it white boys. She literally does the H. You know, where or when. She does all the H's. I'm obsessed with that because I so didn't grow up with proper diction. And she's amazing at it. So it's just nonstop. White boys. So some of the things I want you to hear, I love that it begins with the bass, the dong, 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 and then the piano riff. I just love the simpleness. Then Melba does her white boys, and I also love how between every verse, she has to do a sassy well, or a whoa, or a I tell you that. The first one is, I tell you that, a white boy. She does all these cute, just leading into the next verses. And I love her vibrato on shoulder. Shoulder. Just everything is vibratoed. Okay, here she goes. So good. White boys, bass, piano riff, white boys.
White boys are so pretty, skin as smooth as milk. White boys are so pretty, hair like Chinese silk.
That.
Touch my shoulder, that's the touch that kills.
Okay, well, then we go into the bridge. Of course, she has to do a well. There always has to be a leading word. It's the next session. So it's well. I love the vibrato on calls. My mama calls. Just amazing vibrato. My daddy told. So it's on all the verbs, there's vibrato. Calls, whether it's present tense or passé composé. Anybody French? Told. Vibrato on that as well. Then just crazy belting E's. Just... just amazing vibrato on an E. She's like, why wouldn't I have vibrato on it? I don't know, maybe because it's high? Not for me. Okay, so amazing vibrato on the E. Amazing H before a white. And then the melody is supposed to go, every time they're near me, every time they're near me. But of course she does sassy near me, just sassafras. Here we go.
That's the touch that
well. Right on toe.
My daddy told me stay away.
Here comes an E. It is so well placed, isn't that vibrato? It's so easy for her. She goes. Melody. Modulation. So then old school modulation by old school Barry Manilow. I just love that it goes from E to F. Every time they're near me, I just can't get enough. Hey, what? I love a good modulation. Then the trumpets come in. Gonk, dig-a-dong, gonk, dig-a-dong. Two and four, signature two and four. Did a clapping, two and four. Anybody had a succeed? Anyone watch that one? Or has it not been on yet? I don't know what order this. Oh, it's not been on yet. It'll be on for the revival. Stop talking about it. Okay, so two and four with the horns. Here we go.
I just can't get enough. Oh, white boys are so pretty. White boys are so sweet. White boys drive me crazy. Drive me in the street.
Oh, see, always something. Always something. She can't let you be scuffed. Just love that. I love this. The lyrics are crazy. I love those sprayed on trousers. Sprayed on trousers? I guess they're so tight, they look like they've just been sprayed on. And then love the love machine. What's the love machine? That's what I think it is. Okay, here we go.
It's so long and mean. I love those sprayed on trousers. Love the love machine.
I know what it means, but I love it. Okay, here we go. Then she goes to the bridge. Yeah, my brother. Here we go. Listen to this. And then there's an amazing F coming up because she was, you know, she was on an E in the old key. Now it's an F. Why wouldn't I be able to belt it? I don't know, because maybe nobody else can. Okay, here she goes. She's amazing.
Love the love machine.
Goes it.
Yeah, my brother calls him rubble. That's my kind of trouble.
Get ready for the F. Get ready. This is the vibrato on boys. It is so well placed. Okay, what is the background? Guitar. Guitar? I literally know what they're saying. First of all, it's so upstaging. It's like, you know what? Shut up for a second. And I know what you're saying. Guitar. Guitar. Okay, listen. It makes no sense. Hold on. Make an F. Okay, then here's the part where I do like the backup, because they just start talking, they just start going, sock it to me, sock it to me. Like, it's just weird, Aretha Franklin reference, sock it to me. So I just like that they're just, it's not even singing anymore, they're just speaking. It went from guitar to sock it to me. And then just lyrics that I don't think anybody knows at the very end. Give me a tall. She goes, that very ending, she's saying mixed media, because it's, the song before was Black Boys, so the girls come back out, AKA Diane Keaton and her two backup girls, come back out and they're seeing black boys, white boys, black boys. Finally they go mixed media. But it just sounds like, you have no idea what they're saying. And by the way, tip of the hat to my friend Whitney Mallon's mother, who never knew the lyric at the end of Evita. You know, when she goes, just a little touch of star quality. Her mother always thought it was, just a little torture starts with the T. Why is she Harold Hill? And that rhymes with P. Okay, here we are.
Girl, give me a
what to you? Thank you. Now, crazy unintelligible lyric. Who knows what they're saying? Mixed media. Why an earthquake? Okay, wait. I just love the earthquake. Why is it an earthquake? Thank you. Dressed in a suit, Annie Hall style. Not really. Oh, earthquake. I'm gonna fall. Bye-bye.